All right, what's happening, everyone? Jay Shockblast here, and check it out. Another new hero has arrived. That's right, X-23, and I have a feeling this is going to be one of the most popular characters in the game. You know, right now I'm running around with Nova and Dr. Doom, so let me just go over to my favorite place to show off characters, this corner right here. Go ahead, bust out my roster, and boom, here she is. Laura Kinney herself. She is the clone of Wolverine.
I feel pain.
And there she is with her spiked boots and double claws. That is her default costume. She also has her Fang costume. She also has her X-Force costume. And she has her Target X costume. So they're just calling X-23 classic costume for this one, I guess. I am not the biggest X-23 fan. To be honest with you, my biggest exposure to her is through the Avengers Academy storyline, where we obviously knew she wasn't going to die because she pretty much can't die. Since she's a clone of Wolverine, who apparently can die. So, I don't know what I'm talking about, apparently. Definitely. I think I got this costume from buying the Advance Pack. Not really quite sure. Somebody will definitely tell me. I definitely know a little bit about her from X-Force as well. Not, like, again, one of my most favorite characters, and quite frankly, as far as this game is concerned, I really don't play Wolverine very much, so I don't know if it's a character I'm going to play as too often. So she's got adamantium claws, deadly operative, and lethal acrobats, cleaving claws. Obviously going to be a melee character, crimson sweep, ripped to shreds, slash and hack, bloody harvest, disembowel, and seeing red, graceful maneuver, heart of a beast, so some passive stuff, fluid stance, ferocious stance, so they basically boost kind of some of the other skills. Dancing Blades, Signature, Melee, Movement, and Covert Assassin, Stealth. So, let you go Stealth. Then you have Lethal Acrobat. Caporia? I'm not going to lie, I don't know how to pronounce that. Cyclone Kick, Lethal Claws, Twirling Lunge, Open the Jugular. I like it. Rending Leap and Whirling Dervish. Oh my gosh, these like powers are like so brutal. So brutally violent. I always like to give Cyclops here. I don't really care about rare item find. I managed to get Rogue, health on a hit, and Punisher up to 25 recently. I'm going to give that physical damage from Thor. Brutal strike chance from Wolverine. What does she give? Damage versus bleeding and damage versus bleeding. I've got to give her Hulk for the extra life. Somebody else gives extra life. I think Colossus maybe. Yeah, I brought Colossus up to level 25 for that reason too. So right now I'm giving her plus 9% on health. So she goes from 519 to 565. Hey, every little bit counts, right? So, who else has melee? Okay, Nightcrawler. Physical power, crit chance. Moon Knight. And yeah, I don't care about dodging probably nearly as much as I should. Ah, whatever. I'm just gonna give her a cap. So there we go. So for this video, I'm gonna show the Target X costume. And then I don't think I'm gonna do four separate videos. Well, maybe I will. I don't know. I'm gonna go level her up a little bit real quick, and when we come back, we will be in Industrial City or Industry City, whichever it is, and we'll check her out after I've got a couple extra powers. Yeah, that's it. That's all I gotta know. So we'll be back in a snap. All right, and like I said, here we are at Industry City Patrol. We need to go find some Magi and Mercs. The thing I really like about Industry City is it's really fast-paced. And, you know, all you have to do is participate in some way, shape, or form. Like, in the, basically in the events that are going on. So, like, killing some thugs, killing some mercs, killing some magi. All you have to do is participate by killing, like, one. One, and you get credit for being a part of it. So, that could be a challenge with how fast everything kind of goes. So, boom, just like that, I got my Industry City reward box. I already picked it up pretty fast. So, that's really kind of what I like the most about this. Now we're going to go down here. We're going to fight all these baddies. So, X-23 is pretty beast. I mean, I honestly just sit here and walk around with my two mouse buttons smashing down left and right, left and right, left and right. You gotta have a nice balance of, you know, standard attacks, because that's how you get your wrath back. Wrath is the, you know, right here, your energy, I guess you will, to do all your better attacks. What I really like is that her movement power does not take wrath, and I use that a lot just to kind of skedaddle, if you will, to move around a bit. I only have a couple basic powers so far. I don't know if I mean, I know I'm fighting a bunch of bosses right now, so it shouldn't be that easy, but I'm about to get hit. Oh, snap. Alright, so level 25 already, as you can see. The perks of having, like, tons of boost took my eye off the game for a second. I'm just going to stay here and get all this XP and hope somebody revives me.
Magneto, your probability for betrayal is high. I will watch you closely. Almost beat Thor with
this move. This awesome person right here that's trying to really bad. Downside is this is definitely a hard area to get revived at. Because there are just so many enemies. But I'm getting XP for being dead right now. Although all my XP orbs there are diminishing. See. There's just so many enemies, you know. I don't think I'm gonna get revived. Alright, whatever. I'm just gonna revive myself. Get all the XP. Well, that sucked.
Guess I'm the last man standing. Again?
Yeah, so I feel like I level up way faster over here. And I just absolutely lost track. I knew I was like low on health and everything, but I just kind of lost track of everything. So I have a running with Brood Wolverine because it's really the only kind of thing, team up that makes sense. So like right now, I really, really like, Crimson Sweep. Uses a decent amount of wrath. I've also invested into Hack and Slash. Let's see. I don't know which stance I'm going to go with. I'm going to definitely get a stance. But I'm surprised there's not any other passive. Oh, there we go. No, there's no revive. I guess I just kind of feel like there should be, kind of like Wolverine has, like, I don't know, a couple of characters you just don't die. So, anyway, I'm just gonna go ahead and make sure that is all boosted, and get Brood Wolverine back in here. I'm just gonna open my two industrial cities, take all that XP. Take a couple of those and open my other one. Boom. All right. So I'm going to go back up here. Warp to location. I want to get to like the higher level one. So here we are. Another instance. Go ahead and guess I didn't really upgrade too much, huh? Definitely an upgrade there. Alright, that's a good enough upgrade. So,
don't tell the boss about this.
So that attack right there, ripped to shreds, totally lethal. Just totally ruin your day. Come on. I feel like I'm a little late to the party here. It's amazing how many people are enjoying running around with Juggernaut, even still with both Magneto and X-23 having just launched. Juggernaut is definitely one of the most fun characters to play as. So, where are the overseers? Aim overseers. Gotcha.
Are you listening to me? Oh, do fall down.
We've got the leader. Stop time to pick up the strategy.
Prototype test. You're such a pest. You embarrass yourself. You are weak.
I hate it when the XP explodes that way.
Trust me, this could have been more painful.
My leg!
Yeah, I'm aware that there's tons of stuff over here. Alright. So yeah, man, everything happens really fast and furious in Industrial City, and I kind of enjoy that aspect. Just go ahead and there we go. Very nice. Do one more event and then we'll call it a video. So yeah, here's an example of what I love about Industry City. All you have to do is one thing. I'm going to save this one guy, alright? Now every time somebody saves somebody, I don't really have to save anybody else, but every time people do, I'm going to get the XP. And then once the, see, just like that. Once the event is over, I'll get the reward. Even though I have, you know, saved three of them right here. Four of them. You know, it's definitely rewarding because I, you know, with Midtown Manhattan, one of the, see, there it is. I'm getting, like, other people are getting them. So, with Midtown Manhattan, one of the things I kind of disliked was, you know, there were times where somebody would have, like, a super or something, and every few minutes you had the event, and somebody would go, do a boss battle and, like, just destroy everybody before you could even get to where they are on the map. So this is a little bit more spread out. And see, there's my Industry City reward box. And, you know, all you have to do is contribute somewhere on the map. So right here, I'm going to go ahead and kill a symbiote. And just like that, I've contributed. And all I have to do is be here once it hits 100. And I'll get my Industry City reward. Now, obviously, I'm going to be here longer than that. But, you know, point remains. You cannot win. There have been times where I've, like, loaded up into, this area and literally killed one thing within 2 seconds and gotten my, Industry City reward. So, boom, there's that. Now we're gonna go fight Venom. Wherever he is. Oh, there he is. The downside, the sacrifice you make, is it's a little bit harder in Industry City, which, you know, for whatever. I know a lot of people are totally into, like, the harder difficulties and stuff. So it is a little bit harder and way faster pace. Like, everything, I feel like the respawn rate is much higher. So you kind of have to stay on your toes much more. It'll be 30 here in a minute. Definitely the fastest I've ever gotten a character leveled this high. Thank you, boosts. That's what happens when you spend $60 on boosts today. By the way, if you watch me on open up those 72 packs, I did end up buying another 36, and I did get my Guardians of the Galaxy Iron Man, and I did get my, I got a thing, and I got Mr. Fantastic, so not overly concerned with those. Those aren't exactly hard to get. Cerebro remote interface, yes, I would like that. Alright, cool. So let's go back up to the Avenger Tower, and we will call it a video. I think I'm going to make one other video for her with the Fang costume. So there she is, X-23, Miss Laura Kinney. I have her up to level 29. Hope everybody enjoyed the video. I'm not, again, the hugest of X-23 fans, but she does play really well. Definitely a lot of fun to play with, so... hope you guys enjoyed again, and we'll catch you later. See ya.